Number two about to get underway. There's first pitch. It's a ball 1-0. Or the Wildcats. Ooh, that one's lace foul. Doug Wadup's getting out of the way down there. For the Wildcats, Nolan Milliman on the bump, making his first start of the season. 8 appearances, 16 innings, a 6.75 ERA, a record of 1-1. 2-1 the count. Opposing hitters, though, just a .242 average against him. It's Carson Green, Hayden Fultz, and James Anderson in the first inning. And it's Cooper Dulick, Justin Lutz, Mason Powell, A.J. Wagonman behind the plate, P.J. Osmus, and Dominic Busso. Not a whole lot of changes for the Yellow Jackets. And for Central Washington defensively, as that one's up and in, it's 3-2. Van Kempski's over at first, the second baseman, Charlie Larson, at third, it's Michael Peter. The shortstops, Trevor Tripoli, left to right, Berryman, Fossil, and McLean. Down by way of the K is Carson Green. Austin Olin behind the plate. Now batting right fielder, number 13, started game one over at first and got flipped behind the plate after the Wildcats pinch hit for Colby Musselman. On the ground, right side, Larson from the hole, got him. There are two down here in the top of the first.
Now batting first baseman, number 20, James Anderson.
Swing and a miss by Anderson. He was 1-for-6 in game number one, scored twice, drove in a pair. One's out of play. Count still 0-2. Trying to get him to chase and he wouldn't offer. Anderson. Fouled that one off of himself. And now Torrey Atencio coming out. He seems to be okay. He'll get back in the box. And that'll be the first hit of the ball game. A two-out knock extends the inning. Rounding first, heading for second. The throw, the tag. He's in there! A little swim move. Charlie Larson's trying to say he got him. That was a nice swim move by Anderson. Cooper Dulick will stand in. You're only presented that opportunity as a runner very rarely. Ball beat him in. The tag was there, and he just went around it. Two-out double. And it's chop foul by Dulick. Swing and a miss. A heavy swing there from Dulick. Ooh, that one just misses. 1-2. Up the middle, Larson. One hops the throw. He's in there. Nice pick by Van Kempski, but it won't matter. He beat the throw. So that one fouling back out of play. And a check on the runner at first. Pretty small lead over there, and he's back standing up. Runners on second and third. Now the Wildcats didn't play into the old delayed steal. Playing Lutz to pull. Swing and a miss. That'll end the inning. Berryman, Fossil, and Olin due up for Central in the bottom of the first. Bottom of the first. Zach Berryman leading off at 362. Five home runs and 28 driven in. Standing on the mound for the Yellow Jackets is Connor Redmond. Seven appearances, all starts, one complete game. 31 2/3 inning. 6.25 ERA in the opposing team's hitting 301 against him. Struck in the air to center, twisting, and the catch will be made by Green. Here's Adam Fossil. 3-for-4 in game number one. Scored three times. Drove three in. Foul back and out of play, 0-2. Fouled away. The 0-2 is popped up right side. Anderson tracks it down for out number two. That one gave him a little bit of trouble getting back there. Olin fists this one down the first baseline. It kicks off the glove. And the Wildcats have their first runner on the error. Larson hitting 290 on the year. A pair of home runs and 16 batted in. Redmond misses 1-0. In the dirt. Oland faked taking off, drew a look from Wagonman. Up and in. And it's a four-pitch walk for Larson. Should have done it with J.C. 2 years more than a year. First pitch to Copeland. Swung on and missed 0-1. The 0-1 to Copeland. Low, 1-1. Copeland chases down and in. 1-2 the count. Runners on first and second. Wildcats with a little life here in the bottom of the first. Ooh, Copeland holds off. Thought about chasing after the high stuff. Fouled away. In the dirt. Count runs full. Wagonman kept it close enough. Everybody asked to stay put. Copeland down, swinging the Wildcats, strand two. Top of the second, coming up after this. Mason Pyle gets the top of the second going. 3-11. He went 4-for-5. 3 runs scored and 4 batted in. Foul tip back into the mitt. Count 1 and 2. And he gets him swinging for out number one. There's Wagonman, the catcher, 243. 2 home runs, 9 batted in, back behind the dish. And that'll be a single over the head of Trevor Tripoli. Third hit of the game for Montana State Billings.
Now batting second baseman number 3, PJ Osmus.
Over for a called strike from Milliman. Big swing and a miss there from Osmus. Filled in for Godfrey after Godfrey left with an injury yesterday. Been the second baseman ever since. One ball and 2 strikes. Runner going and a good piece of hit and run right there. Oh, he almost lost an edge rounding second. It'll be runners on the corners. Good piece of hitting there by Osmus. Runner moving, he slaps it backside for the single, and it's runners on the corners with one down.
Now batting left fielder number 23, Dominic Musso.
Into left, long way to go for Berryman. Runner tagging, and he will score with a slide. Billings takes a 1-0 lead here in the top of the second inning. First pitch ball. Inside, 2-0. all the strike. Count now 3-1 to Carson Green. Ball four. Now runners on first and second with two down.
Right fielder number 13, Hayden Fultz.
Chases that one down. Fultz might have needed a 9-iron to hit that one. To first, Oland will take it himself, and that'll end the top of the second. The Yellow Jackets get one, though, and a pair of hits. We'll take a timeout. Bottom of the second coming up after this. Peter leading things off in the bottom half of the second inning. Collected two hits and six at-bats, one run scored, and two batted in game number one. Two and oh to the Wildcats third baseman. Three and one to get me over fastball. That'll be ball four. Leadoff walk for Michael Peter. And here's Andrew Van Kempski. Pinch hit and then move to first in game number one. Catches the corner, a called strike. Two and one the count after that one misses. Towards third base dugout, and it'll fall harmlessly to the ground. Powell gave it a good run. Couldn't quite get there. Runner going, and there'll be a stolen base without a throw. The air to right. Catch will be made, tagging and running. Peter gets to third. Fultz had to shield his eyes from the sun and deal with the wind out there. And with one out, Tyler McLean. Called strike, opens the at-bat at 0-1. One bounces in, Wagonman blocks it. Another called strike. One and two to McLean. Still Stung into center. And, oh, he reeled it in. It'll be a sacrifice fly. And, well, it was an adventure out there. In the air, right center, long run for Green. He's got it. That will end the inning, but the sacrifice fly ties it at one as we head to the top of the third. Top of the third, Milliman back out for Central. Anderson leading things off. Squares to bunt, and it'll be pop over Oland for a foul ball, 0-1. In the air foul, it'll get out of play. Oh, it'll be 0-2. One and two. Looping liner over the head of Tripoli and down. Leadoff single for the Yellow Jackets.
Now batting the shortstop, number one, Cooper Dulick.
Here's Cooper Dulick. Already one hit in the game. Count 1-0. One and one, it catches the inside corner. Check on the runner at first. He's back. And they're going to say he did go around. So that's out number one on the strikeout. Here's Lutch. 0-for-1. Struck out in his first at-bat. And the throw goes in a center. Second error of the ball game for the Wildcats. Or first, excuse me. Second total error of the game. Looking at the wrong column over here. Pitch was a strike and swing and a miss. 0-2. Got him chasing the high stuff.
Now batting third baseman number 12, Mason Powell. Come on, Gary.
Right at Oland at first. He'll make the grab. That's the end of the inning. Still tied. 1-1. Bottom of the third. Top of the order for the Wildcats. Zach Berryman leading things off. If we could just take the wind and move it somewhere else, it'd be a pretty nice day out here. But that wind chill makes it a little uncomfortable down there. Redmond in short sleeves as well. Upstairs. Berryman is 0-for-1 on the day. Time called. And looks like it might be an injury timeout. So Ty Wilson is on in relief, an injury substitution. Redmond looked like he was touching his finger there when he left. So that walk will be charged to Redmond as he left the ball game with a 3-0 count. And here's Adam Fossil. Call the ball 1-0. Two and oh to Fossil. He's 0-for-1 on the day. Redmond did not allow a hit before he left the ball game. Central still looking for their first. Three and oh. And Wilson walks Fossil, so the first two hitters are aboard.
Now batting the catcher, number 13, Austin Olin.
Into right, station to station. So the bases will be loaded as Olin singles. And here's Charlie Nelson. He drew a walk in his only plate appearance. Or excuse me, Charlie Larson. I don't know why I said Nelson. I don't know where I got that from. If you're going to break the game open, now's a good chance. Bases loaded, nobody out. Call the strike on the outside corner. Pumps that one over. It's 0-2. Outside. Wilson having trouble with the command. Some stirring in the Yellow Jackets bullpen. Yeah, down and in. One and two to Larson. Excuse me, 2-2 to Larson. He'll step out, something in the eye. Just misses, counts full. Where to put him. Payoff pitch. Ball four. That'll make it 2-1. As Berryman scores on the walk. Opens the at-bat with a strike, 0-1 to Michael Copeland. Down the line and fair. Oh, foul. Never mind. Just foul. Oh, that ball came back. Somebody take the ball from Cooper. Dulick was just kind of standing in short with the ball up like, what do I do with it? Nobody wanted it. Just put it in your back pocket, save it for a rainy day. Down looking is Copeland. Here's Michael Peter.
Now batting third baseman number 8, Michael Peter. He's gonna walk into the box just like.
At least he didn't throw it and hit Wilson. I think it was Eric Chavez when he was with the New York Yankees. And that one gonna go for a wild pitch. It's 3-1. Down and in. Peter fouls that one off the screen. Peter swings and misses, it gets away, and they retire him 2-3 for the putout. The wind is not let up. Here's Van Kempski. That one's called a strike. Okay. one's called a strike. Good block by Wagaman. Right-hander throwing for the Yellow Jackets. And another walk from Wilson. A rough outing from the bullpen for him. Check swing, and he did go around, says the home plate umpire. Fouled away. Wagaman had to track that one down. The mask comes flying off. It's a full count. Two outs. Runners should be going. And a spin and a look at second. Three-two, swing and a miss. Struck him out to end the inning. Wildcats leave them loaded. They get two. It's a 3-1 game heading to the fourth. There's A.J. Wagonman, 1-for-1 on the day. Milliman back out there for Central. Wagonman takes one inside. And it'll be foul. One and two, the count. Swing and a miss. It's in the dirt. The throw to first. That retires Wagonman for the inning's first out. And now it's P.J. Osmus. He's also 1-for-1. That one's over for a strike, 0-2. In the dirt. Olin keeps it close by. Fouled away. Another one in the dirt. It's 2-2. Line drive in a center, and that'll be down for a hit. Hit number 6 for the Yellow Jackets. And despite that, they do only have one run. That's going to be a wild pitch. Motoring on up to second. Osmus now in scoring position. And that's through for a single. Wadup's waving the runner around from third. It'll be 3-2. Here's Green. Breaking ball stays up high. Want to know? Looks like Goodsworth throwing in the Wildcats bullpen. Swing and a miss. Milliman's got to get out of this inning to be eligible for the win. Oh, Milliman's hat's going away. Reminds me of when Mackenzie Gall pitched at Central. Every pitch, his hat would come off. One and two the count. Check on the runner at first, back in time. Osmus will take second. Nolan needs a second behind the plate. Got him looking for out number two. I'll bring up Hayden Fultz. He's 0 for 2 in the ball game. On the ground, that'll sneak through. Fossil not going to be able to field it, and the run will score. That'll be a single on an RBI. It's a 3-3 game.
Now batting first baseman number 20, James Anderson.
James Anderson, 2 for 2. Kramer Champlin's going to come out. And they'll go to the bullpen, so we'll take a timeout. We'll be back right after this. So Goodsword comes on for the Wildcats. He's got a runner over at first and two down. First pitch is fouled away by Anderson. He replaces Nolan Milliman, who allowed three runs on eight hits. Though the runner aboard is still his, so the book not fully closed. This is in the air to right center, and that is going to get down. Wadup's waving the runner around from third. Here comes the throw. It's offline. The slide. He's in. And advancing to third on the throw is Anderson. 3-for-3 with an RBI, and the Yellow Jackets have the lead. Milliman four runs now. That one just misses. Two balls and a strike. Peter to first, and they retire Dulick 5-3, but they do push across 3, and they lead by 1. 4-3 as we head to the bottom of the fourth. One run lead for the Yellow Jackets, and it's 9-1-2 for the Wildcats. Tripoli, Berryman, and Adam Fossil. One and oh to start off the inning. Wilson back out there. He allowed one hit, one earned run, three walks. But he did strike out 3. Chop to short. Dulick to first. They got him. Four out number one. Back to the top of the order here is Zach Berryman. 0 for 1 on the day. The Wildcats with just one hit. First pitch skips in. Two and oh. Here's the 2-0. Big swing and a miss from Berryman. He was sitting on one pitch, got it, and just missed it. It's always the temptation is to swing out of your shoes on a 2-0, but you got to be a little controlled and measured. As he goes after that one, it's 2-2. In the air to right. Camping under it. Hayden Fultz. He could have unpacked a picnic on that one. He took half a step to his left and was right there. Here's Fossil with two down. Swinging first pitch, lifts this one into the gap in right center. Off the wall. Fossil digging for two. He'll have that standing up. It's a two-out double. It's Austin Olin. One for two. Down in the dirt. Fossil dancing off a second. Has to scamper on back. Bender on the outside corner. Starting to enter the twilight period here. The shadows taking over. Being cast from the tree line down the third baseline. That one gets away from Wagonman. And Olin will take, Fossil will take third. Moves up 90 feet. And with two outs, the sacrifice fly is off the table. Foul tip back into the mitt. It's 2-2. Chopped, foul down the third baseline. Reset, try the 2-2 once more. High and deep to left. That's going to get down. Olin, the end of second with a double. F- Fossil scores. It's 4-4. Here's Charlie Larson. Has an RBI. Hit a long sacrifice fly to center. Fouled away, 1-1. That'll be a pass ball. Olin advances to third. I don't know what happened on that one, but Wagonman didn't make the grab. In the dirt, it's 3-1. Copeland's on deck. That'll be a walk for Larson. Here's Copeland trying to avoid the hat trick. He's already struck out twice. Oh, and one after the foul ball. That ball's not coming back. Copeland fouls it away, 0-2. Oh, 2 count with 2 outs, 2 on, 1 across in the inning for Central. Runner going, chopped up the middle. That'll be through for a single. Copeland gives the Wildcats a 5-4 lead. Here's Michael Peter. Peter 0-1. He's walked once and struck out once. Lefty on lefty matchup. With 2 outs, he gets the bunt down. The throw to first. That'll retire Peter. The Wildcats push 2 across. They lead it 5-4 when we head back for the 5th after this. Top of the fifth starts with a strike to Justin Lutz. He is 0 for 2 with two strikeouts, trying to avoid the hat trick. Outside. It goes hat trick, golden sombrero, platinum sombrero. Swing and a miss. 1-2. I don't know what happens if you get six strikeouts in a game, but I hope your coach isn't allowing that. That was actually the response from Gabe Kapler when I worked for the Greenville Drive. I asked him, I was like, what's after the platinum sombrero? And that's when he said, yeah, I'm just not going to let anybody get there to find out. A little bloop single with two strikes for Lutz. 10th hit of the game for MSUB. There's Mason Powell. He's 0 for 2. Swinging at the first pitch, he's fouled it away. It was a fun couple of years working for the Greenville Drive as a bat boy, 2007, 2008. One of the nicest ballparks in minor league baseball, Floor Field. Breaking ball inside. 1-1. Met a whole bunch of future major leaguers. As this is stung into left on a line. Back-to-back hits for the Yellowjackets. And their offense asking questions now. Here's A.J. Wagonman, 1 for 2.
Now batting to catcher number 6, A.J. Wagonman.
There is action in the Wildcats bullpen. So the runner at second and delivers. Squares around a bunt. Fouls it off. That looked like a good pitch to bunt. Olin calling out the bunt defense. It's a short lead at second. Squaring around, pushing it to first. They're going to have time to go to third. They do. Oof. Not a good way to get the first out for Montana State Billings. You want to be a little more productive than that.
Now batting second baseman number 3, PJ Osmus.
One down in the inning. PJ Osmus, 2 for 2. Blocked, and the wild pitch will do what the sacrifice bunt could not. So they get their runners on second and third with one out regardless. Fouled away. 1-1 the count. On the ground. Game will be tied, but they retire Osmus at first, a productive ground out for him. He'll get the RBI, and it's 5-5.
Now batting left fielder number 23, Dominic Musso.
Here's Dominic Musso. Yellow Jackets searching for the lead. Ooh, high and tight. It's 1-0. Two balls, no strikes. Musso 1-for-1, a pair of RBI. Three and oh, and Goodsworth's not happy with that one. Three and one. Hit high and shallow the left side, triply going back. Berryman's going to call him off. He'll make the grab to end the inning. The Yellow Jackets push across one. Tie ball game with just two innings left. 5-5. Andrew Van Kempski will lead off here in the bottom of the fifth. Ooh, Wilson lays in a fastball for 0-1. That caught a lot of plate. Here's the 0-1. It'll be 1-1. The lefty misses down. Two and one. Wildcats first baseman. Three and one, misses just below the knees. That'll be a walk for Van Kempski. Line Imir is going to run it first. So Desi Story dipping into his bench. That's going to be a base hit for Tyler McLean. Runners on first and second, nobody out. Wagaman keeps it close. Everybody stays put. Oh, time's called by the batter. Triple E will step back in with a 1-0 count. The bunt is down. Well placed down the third baseline. They got him! Nice pick at first by the second baseman, P.J. Osmus. Top of the order for Zach Berryman. Runners on second and third with one down. Billings infield. Playing about halfway. Upstairs 1-0. Anderson and Powell are even with the bag. Osmus is pulled a few steps back of the grass line. In the dirt 2-0. Dulick playing a little bit further back over at short. Called strike. Into the air and down. That will score at least one. Second run will score as well. It's 7-5. Wilson's now allowed 5 runs, 6 hits, and 5 walks out of the bullpen. Fossil looking for his second hit, fouls that one off the screen. It has not been a good day to be a pitcher in this game. Or in game number one. Yeah. 55-foot fastball jumps around Wagonman, and it's a wild pitch. In the dirt again. Wagonman will go out and have a chit chat. And now making the jog back. Two and one the count. Grounder up the middle. Osmus on the hop. The throw, that'll be out number two. Moves the runner ahead 90 feet. Holland, 2-for-3 with an RBI. Swing and a miss there. It's 0-1. Larson waits on deck. Still no official at-bat for him. Got an RBI and three walks. Oland skies this one to center, and it'll be caught by Green for the third out. The Wildcats push across two more. They've scored in the last four innings at least one run, and it's 7-5. Drew Richardson takes over at first after Divine Imir ran for Andrew Van Kempski. Gounsword back out on the bump. First pitch to Green is up and in. He's 0 for 2, a walk and a pair of strikeouts. Trying to stave off the hat trick. Yeah. In the air to right, McLean. A little bit of an adventure out there for him, but he grabs the liner for out number one. Quick out here in the top of the sixth. Here's Hayden Fultz. Look at that bird trying to get to the top of the netting there. It was struggling to get the updraft with the wind. You might have the best seat in the house over there. Two and oh, the count to Hayden Fultz. He's 1-for-3 with an RBI. Yeah, it's over first strike. It's 2-1. It's foul back and out of play, 2-2. Anderson is on deck. And he's had a very good day at the dish, 3-for-3. I want to give him any chance to drive anybody in. Right-hander throwing for the Yellow Jackets. And that'll be a punch out. Fultz down looking. Two outs, it's Anderson. Oh, oh, oh. Outside, 1-0. Sky high, twisting right. That's going to go to right field. Coming against McLean, and he's got it. That's a 1-2-3 inning. That ball started at second base. Bottom of the sixth, Central leading 7-5 coming up. Bottom six, Charlie Larson leading off. Still looking for his first official at-bat. Got an RBI and three walks on the ledger. In for the Yellow Jackets is the right-hander Brooks Zimmer. 3 2/3 innings pitched, a 5.73 ERA. He struck out five and allowed five hits. That'll be out number one. Here's Michael Copeland. He's 1 for 3, an RBI and two strikeouts. Swing and a miss there from Cope. It's 0-1. Oh, and two. Bit of a short arm delivery there from Zimmer. Doesn't have that pullback reach like most guys do. Reminds me a little bit of Keith Foulke. Former Oakland Athletic, Chicago White Sox, and of course the Boston Red Sox, where he closed out the World Series, and that's a hat trick for Copeland. Third strikeout for him, and with two down, that'll bring up Michael Peter. And that will be out number three. Central goes down 1-2-3-7-5 as we head to the top of the seventh. Top of the seventh inning. Gouds were back out there, and Cooper Dulick will lead things off. Two and oh. Both of those down in the dirt. Now hitters are going to have that much harder of a time as the shadows have cast across the mound and the ball going in and out of the shadows on its way to the plate. That was Nolan Ryan's favorite time to pitch, right at dusk. On the ground, a short, Tripoli bobbles it, the throw. It'll get away. It'll be an E6 in the book. second error the Wildcats have committed.
Now batting for the DH, number 22, Justin Lutz.
Lutz, 1-for-3. Tying run is at the dish. Tying run's going to be on base. Digging for third. The Wildcats keep Lutz at first, though, so it's runners on the corners. Nobody out. And Kramer Champlin's coming out. He'll go to the bullpen, so we'll take a timeout. We'll be right back. So with runners on the corners and nobody out, Nolan Murphy takes over looking for a save. Swing and a miss from Powell to start the AB. Murphy's thrown 12 1/3. He's allowed 10 hits, 7 strikeouts, and an ERA of 4.5. That'll be two. Richardson makes the snag at first, steps on the bag, and that is about as good as you can get out of the bullpen on two pitches. That is precisely what Central Washington needed. AJ Wagonman, 1-for-3. Good block by Austin Olin. He's gotten a workout back there in this game. That one's called a strike. 1-1. 2-1. Pop foul, twisting. That'll be out of play. The 2-2. 3-2. Jackets down to their final strike. Payoff pitch. That'll be a two-out walk. A little life for the Yellow Jackets. Here's Osmus, 2-for-3 with an RBI.
Now batting second baseman number 3, PJ
Osmus. Fouled away. And won the count. Murphy trying to finish this one out. Two and one. On the ground, right side and through. It'll be 7-6, motoring into third. It's runners on the corners again. Kramer Champlin coming out. He's going to have a chit chat. Two down, two on, one in, a one-run ball game. Tying run 90 feet away. It's 1-0. Dominic Busso, 1-for-2 with two ribbies. Foul tip back into the mitt. 1-1. Foul back at the screen. Jackets down to their final strike. Murphy's set. The 1-2. Even at 2-2. Breaking ball outside. Lined in a left. Berryman, it's going to fall. It's a tie ball game. 7-7. A blown save for Murphy. And the Yellow Jackets still threatening with runners on first and second. And the Wildcats will go to the bullpen, so we'll take a timeout and be right back. Oh, it's Gabe Bustamante trying to put out the fire. He came on in relief yesterday as well. No, he pitched. Was it today? It was today, I think. You're right. Let me get my box score out and I'll check. Yeah, he pitched an inning and 2/3 in game one. Count is 3. Well, it's a ball 4, 4 pitch walk. So here's Fultz. Seven ball game. Fultz 1-for-4. He's got an RBI and a strikeout. The 0-1. Down and in, Oland. Does a nice job of keeping that one tight. The 1-1. 2-1. Nowhere to put him. After 24 hits in Game 1, Billings with 14 here in Game 2. Central, 19 hits in Game 1, just 6 in the back end. Fouled off the screen, 2-2. Two, 3-2. Payoff pitch with the bases loaded. That's ball four, and Billings has taken an 8-7 lead. Can't defend walks and home runs. I imagine Desi Story's lineup card looks a lot like my box score. Crumpled up. Swinging first pitch, lifted to right, McLean to his right. And he'll make the grab. He'll end the inning, but not before Billings takes the lead 8-7. Bottom seven coming up after this. Eight to seven, swinging first pitch, Richardson. And Green hauls it down. Zimmer's 2 outs away from a W. Here's Tyler McLean. 1-for-2 on the day. He's swinging first pitch. Rolls that one to the left side. The throw, did he hold the bag? He did. Two down. Wildcats down to their final out. Here's Tripoli 0-for-3 in this one. First pitch, a called strike. Yeah. Oh, and two, big bender in. Uncle Charlie for a strike. Sky to the right side. Osmus drifting back to his left. And he's got it. Billings comes from behind to take it 8-7. They score 3 in the 7th. Zimmer picks up the win. Murphy will be charged with a loss. Wildcats drop 3-4 to Montana State Billings. And they'll be back on the road after this. So for all of us here at Central Washington, thank you for tuning in. Have a great weekend.